What is up, everybody? This is Upright Cards, and welcome back to King of FanDuel, Week 10. I can't believe it's already Week 10, and last week, ironically, crazy, no one broke the rules, which is great for our contest. We've had some winners that haven't been winners, but they've been losers because they've broken the rules, such as me last week. This week, however, I did not break the rules, and I finally was able to win. I think this was only my second contest of the season. So you guys will be able to hear momentarily see my lineup compared to our second place winner, which was Papa Bear, yep. And it was a tight one. If you guys remember last week, it was rookies only, and it came down to the Miami-Arizona game because that was like one of those 3 o'clock games in our slate where we only do noon and threes. And essentially, Arizona, I think, was like tying it up. Miami kicked a field goal and got the ball back, and all Tua had to do was kneel the ball a couple times. So it went out well. You're going to see a lot of the same players here other than our quarterbacks here. We both had Clyde Edwards-Helaire. We both had James Robinson. I think we both had Justin Jefferson. Yes, we did. Chase Claypool, Jerry Jeudy. We chose the same tight end, the same flex, and then we both chose Pittsburgh's defense. This is the first time I'm seeing this, so it was literally the quarterback that made all the difference. Now, this week, however, we each got to choose a game to choose players from. I chose Houston and Cleveland, while the other guys chose Buffalo, Arizona, and Seattle and LA Rams. I will admit this was a little bit difficult of a lineup to choose from. Ultimately, I'm happy with some of it, not happy with others, and essentially, I chose the cheapest quarterback. Houston at Cleveland, not feeling great about it, but we'll see kind of where things go, and I might resituate, of course, subject to change, but this is where we sit right now. Deshaun, he's averaging about 23 points a game. There were players that cost more. In fact, I think it was every other quarterback out of the games we chose cost more. He was the cheapest. I gave him David Johnson, who is questionable right now, as well as Will Fuller as somebody to throw to. The last couple games, Will Fuller hasn't been getting a lot of targets, but he's made do with what he's gotten, and he's not doing terrible for a decent player or a guy who kind of flies under the radar on a lot of teams. I think if they have better players, he'd be a second or third wide receiver, but he's the main wide receiver after Hopkins has left. We go down to Tyler Lockett and Christian Kirk. I wanted to mix in the guys from the teams I thought would win, and I think these could be some shootouts here in Seattle, LA, and Buffalo, Arizona. Choosing the second wide receiver, essentially, from Arizona and Christian Kirk, I could not make it work, and I could not make myself choose DeAndre Hopkins after some of the weeks he's had here recently. It's kind of hit and miss, and that's just the way it is when you're a great wide receiver, great quarterback, great player. They try to shut you down, and some teams will find ways, and some won't. So Lockett was the other choice. DK cost like $900 more, and I only had, I believe, 800. Yeah, I only had 800. So he was the guy I chose there. Hooper was a cheap tight end who's getting looks. And then we have Cooper Kupp, who is also questionable for that $7,700 with the Texans defense against Cleveland. I mainly chose Texans defense because they're down OBJ. And I thought I saw that Baker had been put on COVID, but he was fine in creating this lineup. It didn't seem like there was anything different. And they're down to their second running back, but he's still a decent running back, so I'm not really worried about that. As you can see, he's in my lineup. So that is it. That is this weekend. That is last week as well. Hopefully we go and we do well. And then next week, we will have another contest, week 11, guys. We're already halfway through this season and already halfway to the playoffs, which is absolutely crazy. Hope to keep this content coming to you guys. Look out for Illusions coming on Friday. Pulled some great rookies, pulled some low-numbered stuff, pulled 3 hits. So I'm looking forward to you guys seeing that. Thank you, as always, for watching. Don't forget to like and subscribe as we sit 3 subscribers away as of now from our giveaway. Have a great rest of your day, guys. Enjoy your football this weekend. Take it easy, stay safe, and I'll talk to you all later.